What's up, guys? How are you doing today? It's Tayo Aina here again, and today I am with Karin Sade,
yes,
who is the designer of this prefab container type house.
Yes.
And today he's going to be sharing his story with us about how he was able to start this business in Nigeria and also the challenges he has faced, and also how he was able to build this successful prefab company. Okay. So, how are you doing? What's up? Nice to meet you.
Thank you very much, Tayo. Thank you for coming. Yeah. I appreciate you being
here. Yeah, I'm glad I'm here too. How did you come about this whole idea of doing prefab houses?
Okay, so I think the story is a little bit of a long story.
Okay. Give us the short version.
I'll give you the shortest version of the story. Yes. But the reality is this. After school, so I schooled in Ghana as an architect. I studied as an architect.
Oh, really?
And then after I finished school in Ghana, I came back to Lagos and I was trying to move out of my parents' house.
Okay.
And it was a struggle. Okay. There was no place I could afford. There was no place I could, you know, and it looked like if you were going to rent a place, you were going to be renting a place and just throwing money with a landlord, and there were no places affordable. So that's actually what started the journey for me. I decided to try, you know, multiple housing typologies and eventually landed on Cargotecture as a solution for people in that age bracket that I was back in the day.
So how old were you then?
At the time I was 20, 21 and a half or 22.
I wanted to move out of your parents at 21 and a half.
I mean, that's every young guy's dream now. You want to come home and be doing the things that you're not supposed to be doing inside your father's house. So, okay. I mean, I think that was really the idea, and that's really the origin of it. How do we solve the problem by allowing people to live closer to where they want to be, that's inside the city, but for an affordable price? And that's what led us to Cargotecture.
Interesting. When did you start this company?
Okay, so the company Seven Spaces started in 2014, 2014, essentially to provide Cargotecture solutions for, I guess, Nigeria. So we do commercial, but we also do residential housing. And this is an example of one of those residential houses that we do, predominantly one bedroom, two bedroom apartment types.
Okay. So is this to solve the real estate problem in Nigeria? Or what do you think? Why build a house with containers? Why don't you build a house with blocks?
Okay, so yes, it's actually to solve the real estate problem. And the major reason why we're doing it with containers is speed.
Okay.
One of the problems that we have in Nigeria in general is that we're not building quick enough for the population that we have. You know, I know that our housing building rate is roughly about 250,000 houses a year. And we need about 20 million houses. If you do the math, it's going to take a number of years. But with this type of structures, you can have a unit like this up in 1 month. You can have, in some cases, units up in less than 1 month. And that's the idea. If we can take housing from brick and mortar to factory assembled or factory built type houses, then we're solving that problem, which means that we can be churning out houses very, very quickly at a much faster rate than we currently build using brick and mortar.
What's your background like generally?
I'm the first child of four. Okay. From a middle class family. I'm an architect by training. Both my parents are medical doctors. And so my architecture was a big deviation from everything that they thought I was going to be. Generally, I'm a fun-loving person. I like to experiment. I'm sure as you guys have seen, push the envelope and then try to see how we can solve problems, you know, in ways that are not necessarily tried or tested in Nigeria as we are today.
Interesting. So starting this company, like, how were you able to come up? Because I'm sure, like, it's not like maybe you had shipping containers somewhere, or maybe somebody, I don't know your story.
Yes.
Maybe somebody did actually shipping containers, or did maybe your father had maybe like one big ship somewhere.
Okay.
And I was like, oh, these containers, take it and come on, easy to do.
The interesting thing is we actually didn't start with shipping containers.
Okay.
In fact, what I actually started with was designing. I designed, you know, a steel, you know, fabricated structure at the time. I was fortunate to even have the first prototype built in China. We shipped it to Nigeria and then it got to Lagos, and, you know, Nigeria does what Nigeria does. You know, things stayed in the ports forever, and then by the time we finally cleared it, you know, there was just no market for it.
Yeah.
And then I started shopping around for a solution. Because I'm in the architecture, you know, space, we come around a lot of containers, you know, we're bringing in tiles with containers. And then I looked at the space. I started seeing what people were doing abroad, you know, in the Netherlands, in some parts of Japan. And then I decided, you know what, a Nigerian can do this. You know, as a person here, why don't I take the risk? And so the first container I ever cut into was in, I think, 2013.
Okay.
That was the first container we ever cut into, you know, just to try and see. We made mistakes along the way. And then we kept refining our processes, watching YouTube videos.
You know, you used to watch YouTube videos?
Oh, yes, definitely. There are a lot of instructions.
Did you watch any of my YouTube videos?
We have watched a few of your YouTube.
Guys, if you're watching and you like the video up to this point, like, subscribe. Okay, continue. I'm listening to you.
Okay, so that's it. And then we tested and kept trying. And then eventually, I think in 2015, I decided to set out and actually set up a company that actually does this. I mean, so we do everything from regular architecture work to Cargotecture. We do for commercial structures, commercial spaces. But we also are now focused on the residential because we think that's where the need is and that's what people need.
Interesting. So from what you said, now what I can get is that you started small.
Yes.
And so your first structure, was it something as big as this? The first one you designed?
Oh, no, the first one we actually designed was bigger than this.
Oh,
which
bigger
is
than
interesting.
This.
But the thing about it is that smaller is not necessarily easier. We found that the smaller your building, the more detailed you have to be about solving problems with where do you store things, storage. So we started actually doing a structure for a church, a commercial structure for a church office.
Okay.
And so after we cut into the containers and we were able to assemble those and we saw that it was functional, we then said, okay, if people can, you know, functionally live or work out of a container, then why don't we push the envelope a little more to say that they can actually live inside the containers? And that's how we did.
Most Africans have a lot of ideas, but funding is always a big impediment. So what is your take on funding and how were you able to get funding on?
Okay, so we actually didn't get external funding. In fact, we did the long route of waiting and trying to, you know, acquire capital by your own self by doing other things within the business. So we designed other buildings and we saved money from within the company and then ventured forth to do the prototype that we're sitting down inside.
Oh, interesting. So you did stuff for other people?
Yes.
Like architectural stuff for other people from what you learned from school?
Exactly.
And then
eventually we're putting money aside.
And started your own project.
Exactly, and then started our own project. So that's how it took a while, obviously. It didn't happen the way the startup world happens where, you know, you raise some big sum and then you go in. But I think that's the phase that we're moving into. Now that we're at this place where we have, you know, done this and we've shown people. But we found that, like I mentioned many times within the video, the residential market is really where the problem is. And because the problem is here, what we're doing is we're taking advantage of, you know, empty plots of land. So there are so many empty plots of land across Lagos.
Yeah, no, I noticed that.
They are owned by people,
but
they are not used.
Yeah.
So what we're trying to say to those people is, there's an asset on your hands. The asset is appreciating in value. Well, why don't you just use that asset to solve part of the problem by leasing it out to young individuals who can buy structures like our structures that are non-permanent. And then when their lease tenure is up, you can literally pick up the units and then take them away.
That's a very interesting model.
And that's what we're trying to do. We're also trying to provide an opportunity for younger people to be able to, or whoever it is that invests, you know, in this type of business, to be able to, I guess, trade real estate in a way that real estate has not been traded before. So for example, we can sell our unit to somebody in Kaduna
without having to be in Kaduna, because we can
put it at the back of the truck.
So it's scalable.
Sell it. So it's scalable.
It's a scalable
extremely
product.
Scalable product.
Wow.
Exactly.
Do you also have plans of creating and shipping out of Nigeria?
Oh yes, definitely. In fact, I think that's the immediate
because
plan.
Forex.
Exactly. And our labor is cheaper. I think there's so many advantages here that we can provide. Labor is cheaper. I mean, access to materials, we can do the basic construction here, we can do the finishing there, but the labor is cheaper and we do have an opportunity to be able to, you know, access the world because people abroad are looking for these type of solutions as well. So the market is open.
Do you believe Africa is the future?
I believe Africa is the future. I believe Africa is the center. And then the future of everything. And it's not just because I'm black. You can see it in our resources, you can see it in our people, you can see it in our culture. The entire world wants what we have. They want our music, they want our style, they want our thought processes, they want our brain. And so why don't we give them our technology? Why don't we give them our energy? Why don't we give them our efforts? And show them that we're more than just dancing and singing and cultural expression, but also deep thinking, problem-solving people.
I know a lot of people have, like recently, everybody has been saying they want to travel to Canada.
Yes.
So why won't you travel to Canada? Why have you decided to build your business in Nigeria? Or do you have plans to travel to Canada?
Let me come out there. I have no plans of traveling to Canada.
Okay.
At least to live long term.
Okay.
It's not in my immediate future as
okay.
of today.
Okay.
So Nigeria as the center. I think beyond belief, I mean, because I'm one of those few people that just believe in our people. I'm not the sort of person to see somebody else do something somewhere else and want it. I can do it here, so why don't I try it? And I think that we have the capacity to be able to provide and solve all our problems within Nigeria, by Nigerians. Not trying to run away. I mean, Africa and Nigeria is especially providing its own issues in this current climate. But I think that if we can weather the storm, we have the numbers, we have the population, we have the brains, and we have the people. So we can solve the problems.
Interesting. You touched on the point now, talking about issues.
Yes.
What issues have you faced? I'm sure you haven't. Everything has not just been smooth sailing, especially building a business in somewhere like Nigeria.
Oh, not at all. I mean, so like I said, the original concept for this thing is very, very old. It's more than 10 years old. The original practice of the business, we started, like I said, in 2015, about five years ago. And we faced challenges from nobody's ever going to live in a container. We've been told that. We've been turned away from meetings. You know, we've had situations where literally the idea is blocked from the onset, because we had to, we probably started our marketing a little too earlier. We needed to wait for the market to catch up to us. So some of the major challenges are people just did not believe that this was possible. And that's why we went through the efforts of building a prototype. And since then, we've had over 100 people come and, you know, view this space, interact within the space. And the feedback is the same. Everyone does not believe what it looks like on the inside. And the space is adequate. The space is more than enough, I'm sure, as you guys have experienced. Mm-hmm. And people are willing to, you know, try, see it out. And we're already getting customers coming in, trying to purchase from us. And we're selling our units.
Interesting. So a unit like this, an average price for a unit like this, like how much?
Currently, a unit like this, and obviously that's exclusive of land, a unit like this is starting at 7 million naira. And then it goes up depending on the finishing that you want. So if you want to change your floors to marble floors, we can do that for you. And that's really what it is. So starting at 7 million naira and then it goes up.
Oh, interesting.
Yes.
So since you started this business, is it lucrative? How lucrative is it?
It is lucrative. It definitely is. It is lucrative. Obviously, we have to engage the market and sell and sell and sell. But it is about as lucrative as it comes. And we believe in the future. We think that the only way from here is up.
My final question for you is, what's your advice to a lot of other young people out there who want to start out in building their own business in Africa?
Yes. Start. That's actually my greatest advice. Start. You're not going to have all the answers. You're not going to know everything when you start, but you will figure it out along the way. I think that it's important to, first of all, get your business idea sound, get a bunch of advisors that you can speak to that can prevent you from making mistakes, and then just start. I know that our generation is very used to quick growth and, you know, scale and all of that. Till the scale comes, start. Build enough of a track record for people to be able to trust your brand or trust you at the time when you scale. So that's my biggest advice to entrepreneurs.
Thanks a lot for
listening
to us with this interview and taking
welcome.
Us around your property.
Thank you.
So
thank
guys,
you.
That's all I have for you today. So you guys should check out this company. I'm going to link it below in the description. If you want to get a prefab house or you want to go into real estate, check him out. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Right. Peace.